What's up? I'm here at Pixar, and I'm about to talk to the geniuses behind the new movie, Cars 3. Let's go. Okay, I'm hanging out here with Michael, with Jude, and with Jay, and these guys are in charge of the design and the animation on Cars 3. What's the biggest challenge when it comes to giving them that personality, but also keeping it almost looking like real life?
It's a car, so, you know, we gotta use the shape of the sheet metal, we gotta use the color and the texture of the paint and the quality of the paint.
Sometimes less is more to try to be true to material, so the fact that these are metal cars and that they are real-ish looking, even though they are cartoon characters.
We've been trained to push things and exaggerate things, and so it takes a while to bring that down, so we're not lifting the car too far off the suspension, and we're not like pushing the mouth too wide.
You know what I do?
What?
I don't know. I got nothing.
Hanging out here at Pixar with three of the masterminds behind Cars 3, Bill, Noah, and Han. Is there a set or a backdrop in this film that you guys are most proud of?
Thomasville, for me, the level of complexity, the vegetation and everything, that we could sort of organize chaos in a beautiful way.
It's a really beautiful set, and a lot of the film is taking old sets and making them new, so like Radiator Springs and adapting that. But this was basically like creating a new Radiator Springs.
Thomasville is really a decaying place that's been kind of abandoned, and then we're able to turn it into a place that has beauty because of the history and the heritage and the meaning behind it.